Council Member Matthew Eugene attend the annual PS249 Cinco de Mayo celebration.
And she is the co-host, and she's going to introduce the next item in Spanish.
Gracias, otra vez. We're going to have the mariachi play some more beautiful Mexican music. Vamos a tener mariachi que va a seguir tocando música. Y vamos a darle un aplauso, por favor.
And we'd like all of the Mexican mothers, if you're from Mexico and your mother, please come forward.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so very much. Good morning. Come on. Good morning, PS249. Good morning. Thank you. My name is Matthew Eugene. And I'm the city council member representing your district, District 40. That will be the district where you are at right now. Today I'm so happy, so delighted to be here for this very special occasion. And I'm happy also because I believe that I belong to the extended family of PS249. And I want to take the opportunity first to thank a wonderful public servant, a wonderful person who is doing a wonderful job with our school, who is doing the best that she can do, that a human being can do, to ensure that our children receive the best education possible. I would like to join me to put our hands together for Principal Miss Brown. Thank you very much, Miss Brown, for what you are doing for our school and for our children and for the great city of New York. And I want to take the opportunity also to thank, because she couldn't do that by herself. She needs assistance, and she has a wonderful staff. And I want to thank also Assistant Principal Miss De Jesus. Thank you very much. I want to thank also Assistant Principal Miss Bath. I want to thank also Miss Hans, Miss Bijagas, and also Mr. Crosby, a wonderful MC. Put your hands together for all of them, please. And to all of you, the parents, from the bottom of my heart, I want to thank you also for what you are doing for your children, for our children, for the children of New York City. You are making the sacrifices to make sure that your children also, they can receive the best education possible. I know it is not easy to raise children in New York City, because I raised two beautiful children too. And for what you are doing for your children, thank you very much. Let's put our hands together for the parents, please. And also to all of you here, all the special guests, thank you for being here today. Today I'm very happy to be here because we are here all together as one community, as one city, as one people to celebrate Cinco de Mayo. And I want to say to all my brothers and sisters from Mexico, felicidades! Felicidades a todos ustedes. You know, you from Mexico, you have a very rich culture. You have a wonderful country. And you contribute so much to New York City and to United States of America. All of us, regardless of where we come from, we owe you a great deal of gratitude. Because you bring vibrancy, diversity in New York City. Thank you very much to all of you from Mexico. Let me conclude by saying that. Estoy muy feliz de estar aquí con ustedes. Tengo un gran placer de estar aquí en este momento muy importante. Importante no solamente para los de México, pero para todos nosotros. Hoy somos todos mexicanos.
First annual National Stroke Awareness Month flag raising ceremony at Maimonides Medical Center.
Also, after that, delighted to introduce our next speaker, who is incredibly passionate about the issue of stroke awareness. I also have to say he's incredibly passionate about Maimonides and his connection to us. I have to say Douglas often uses the line, he's a brother from another mother. It's true. But on stroke awareness, so much that the councilman is working on with us is to advocate for a new citywide stroke awareness and education program to be launched in partnership with us. He brought the idea to us. He's been a champion of it. He's approached this issue as a leader in the public arena. And beyond the issue of stroke, he has been a dear friend and supporter of Maimonides, a bridge builder across the communities he serves, which is part of our identity, and he makes it real in his responsibilities. So let's welcome the councilman for New York's 40th District here in Brooklyn, Dr. Matthew Eugene.
Good morning. First and foremost, let me take the opportunity to thank President Gibbs for his leadership and also to thank all the staff members, his wonderful staff, for what they are doing for Brooklyn and for New York City. And I'm so pleased to say and to repeat that Maimonides is a leader in providing state-of-the-art outstanding medical services to the people of New York City. And I want to take the opportunity also to thank each and every staff member at Maimonides Medical Center, doctors, nurses, medical professionals, because what we are doing for the people of New York City is God's work. Because I say that all the time, health is the most precious gift that we receive from God. It doesn't matter how intelligent you are, how much money that you have, how much power that you have, if you don't have health, forget about it. Nothing counts. That's the reason why it is very important that all of us, doctors, medical professionals, leaders, elected officials, government, we have to team up to protect and preserve this beautiful gift that we receive from God. You all know that stroke is a devastating disease. Stroke is killing so many people, destroying so many families. But guess what? We have what it takes to prevent stroke and to save life. That's what Maimonides have been doing every single day. And that's the reason why I believe this ceremony today is very important. We are going to raise the flag, but what we are doing at the same time, raising awareness about the danger and the seriousness of stroke. Let me say that, just think about it. It is sad. Every time that I'm walking in the street and I see somebody going in one side, or the face go this way or that way, it is sad. It is sad for people who are suffering from stroke to go through that. It is painful. But it is also sad and painful for the family members. Because those people who are suffering from stroke, they are productive citizens, they are productive people, serving the community, providing critical services, outstanding services to the community. When they become patient, or they become, you know, a stroke patient, their life won't be the same anymore. And the most important thing, if they are providing for the family, this family is going to be in trouble. The children are going to be in trouble. And in addition to that, many people, they are going to have a stroke, they don't even know that. It is very important that we continue to team up to provide education, awareness, and make them understand the sign and the symptom of stroke, and they can get the assistance as soon as possible. That's what we are trying to do. Maimonides Medical Center and the City of New York, together, we want to work together to ensure that people can understand the sign, the symptom of stroke, and what to do when they think they are going to suffer from stroke. I'm going to conclude by saying that in addition of providing education and awareness to stroke, myself and our assembly member, our responsibility is to make sure that we got the resources for research and better treatment for stroke. Because we have better treatments now than 20 years before. If we put the proper resources, we will be able to save more life and to do a better service to the community. Thank you very much, and President Gibbs, thank you for this opportunity. And one thing, I would be remiss if I didn't take the opportunity to thank my brother, Douglas Jablon. He's not only a great asset for my money days, but also a good asset to all of us. Thank you, God.
Councilmember Matthew Eugene joined Speaker Corey Johnson and the Jewish community to condemn acts of anti-Semitism in New York City.
Next up, I want to call up a council member who's very proud to represent the large Jewish community here in Brooklyn, Councilmember Matthew Eugene. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. My name is Matthew Eugene, representing District 40, that has also part of Crown Heights and a large organization of Jewish community. But I just want to thank Speaker Johnson for the leadership because under the leadership of the Speaker Johnson, we city council members were working together to pass legislation to ensure that we stand together against anti-Semitism. And I want to take the opportunity also to thank all my colleagues and leaders who are here. You are standing not only for the Jewish community, but you are standing for New York City. Because all of us elected officials, community leaders and also clergy leaders, people in the community, we are working together very hard to make sure that New York City could be a place where everyone can feel free and comfortable to live in New York City and to raise their children. But what we are seeing too often, peaceful people, they're walking in the street doing their business. They are being attacked for no reason. Places of worship are being attacked for no reason. But those crimes of anti-Semitism, they are destroying the core values of New York City. They are destroying the well-being of our city. And this is the reason why we, all of us, we should stand together, continue to stand together, because we have been doing it several times. And I'm so happy to see that we continue to do. Because those who are committing crime, hate crime, they don't stop. They keep doing it. So we have to continue to fight together also. Because we are doing it, not only for the Jewish community, we are doing it for the city of New York. Let me conclude by saying that. The Jewish people are being attacked. But the safety, the peace of the community is the business of all of us. It's the responsibility of all of us, Jewish or non-Jew. We have to stand together to make sure that we make our city a city free of anti-Semitism, free of hate crime. And again, thank you, Mr. Speaker, and thank you to all of us. We are going to continue to do that until we have a city free of hate crime and anti-Semitism. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Matthew.